All that's fine and dandy, but we try to keep that Mr. Rose situation from happening. You get all that contact and all that ground, you get all this new strength, and we got to keep the injury situation from happening because you are contacting the ground different than everybody else right now. That's the thing.
How long you been working with Greg?
Since he's been in diapers. Since he's a little bitty boy. We had this plan since he was really, really, really young. And the crazy thing about it is, like me, like being his god uncle, this was already gonna happen. We talked about this when they were young, you know?
So you're taking credit for the balance.
Huh?
So you're taking credit for the balance.
Well, that's what I do. You'll see in a minute.
Talk about just the workouts you do outside, like what that's all about.
Yeah, it's like plyo times cardio, and it's just like, it's not really for basketball players, but like it's like for track, football, and other sports. But it just like helps me on the court because like it's helping me go faster, jump higher, just do stuff that was normal basketball players do.
We started this, it was funny, man. We started this at 10 for Greg. He's always been the tallest guy in the class, so we knew that we wanted to have him play basketball, so we jumped right into it, like literally day one. He was always one of the taller kids, but he was real goofy, falling down. He like Bambi, literally like Bambi initially. But he started finding success. And with that success, he wanted to continue to play and continue to work.
Me and my dad have it's an on and off relationship. Sometimes we'll get mad at each other for like stupid stuff. But we have a pretty close relationship. We've been having it since 2010, 2011. And he's always pushed me to become the best and nothing less. So I appreciate him for doing that.
The first 3 years for sure, he worked about 345 days. And a lot of those days were two-a-days. We'd go in the morning time before school. We'd also go in the evening time after school. You know, maybe two or three times on a Sunday. That's what propels him more than anything, is that he's gonna outwork most kids. When he was in seventh grade is when we kind of figured he was going along that path, because he was an unranked, unknown kid, and he went up there and just bust head the whole time. And I think they ranked him like sixth in the camp overall afterwards, fifth or sixth, something like that. And it's just kind of been a steady increase over the time. It's no being stagnant. Either you're getting better or you're getting worse. Period. That's how this game works, and that's how every game works.
Craziest thing I've seen Greg do in the game, probably dunking about right here for take a lead late in the game. That was probably the most lit thing that he's ever done.
From Henderson game?
Yeah.
What happened? What happened again?
All I'm gonna say is this man jumped from the free throw line and boom that shit. That's all I gotta say. It was crazy. Is that right, Greg? Ain't that right? You think I'm
gonna... I'm gonna tell you, he had two East Bay dunks. You know what the East Bays are, right? The betweens in a half court set where he was trying to go baseline and just murder a team. Like, he going baseline in a half court set trying to go between his legs. But when he doing it, I'm like, oh, the sky's the limit. Like, he don't care where he go. Like, he finna murder any competition. Like, when you start seeing a guy just go attack baseline in a full motion set, boom, I'm finna go rip. Oh, I'm going between and I'm booming on you. That's ridiculous. That's childish, basically. I just tell him, you childish. You childish for that. But, yeah, that would be the moment that I feel like, okay, he done took this to a whole nother level.
So Greg grabs the rebound. Dribbles, he got like two guys on him, goes behind his back, between his legs, comes down, it's three guys, they're chasing him. It's three guys in and around the paint. Greg literally takes off from one step inside the free throw line and freaking just extends and dunks on all three of those guys. and the crowd went bananas. He's athletic, he's ferocious, and he's just a joy to play with.
Greg ain't Greg, like, if he's not dancing. Basically, like, if he doesn't have that passion going for what he's doing, Greg probably not gonna wanna do it. But like with basketball, you just see it like as soon as he walk on the court. I don't care if he got the flu.
Nobody's ever asked him how I did him one-on-one. How'd you do
him? Oh. I beat him 12-3.
Oh, come on, you lying.
Last time it was 12-0.
Talk about the first time.
I won.
He had like 3 shots, give or take.
I won.
Give or take. I won. I got 3 shots in, give or take.
No, you won.
You won. Yeah, like, I probably got my shot blocked out 4 times. I ain't afraid to admit it. You all right? You nice? You solid? You solid?
When he was in the 7th grade, he looked like a little stick figure. But one thing about him was he had a mindset. And his mindset, I tell a lot of kids that a lot of times about Greg is he was a different kind of mentality that you could tell where his dream was going, how he talked about his passion. Like, he may not have been the best player in the 7th or 8th grade at the time, but anytime he was in the gym, he always telling somebody, I'm gonna be way better than you. Not in an arrogant way, but you can tell he's saying it because I'm working. I mean, I can say that with every kid, that the more they're in the gym, the more their confidence is gonna go through the roof. But mainly, like, especially like with him, it's almost like he can lick his chops once he learns something new. The more he gains more and more, it's just like he wants more. I want more, you know? And that's what I've seen most, more and more as like each year grows. He's getting better and better because of the work ethic and the grind he's putting in. He got the total package. That's what people sleep on. People look at him like he's just a dunker. He's way more than a dunker. Buddy can score in all kinds of ways, but as well, he's playing both ends. He's challenging any kind of shot blocker or dunker on the other end who's trying to dunk on him. He wants that challenge also on a defensive end, which is just, that's great just to have just as a kid.
He said just a dunker, not the wet ball. Not him with the wet ball. I think he said just a dunker.
The second I said it.
Who won't shoot it?
I meant, who won't shoot it?
Go back. Oh, and one.
When he's on the court with top tier, he don't get lost in the whole group. Like, you definitely gonna know who he is. And it's not just because of his dunks. You may see him come off a pin down, catch and shoot off a curl. Like, man, that's nice.
We built him to take on any challenge. If there's a kid out there that's supposed to be the number one guy or whatever the case may be, we're going to find him, and we want to play him. And we want to continue to play him. And that's been our motto since day one. We started off by going off the Pangos when Greg was young. He got whooped on pretty good a couple of those years we went out there. Never forget, he got dunked on something nasty by Cassius Stanley. So with that being said, man, we like to go against whoever to help us get better and learn the game of basketball. And I think he's been doing pretty good to this point.
I'm never satisfied because I feel like I'm the best player in the country. And I'm working to be the best player in the country, just trying to show everybody like I'm that dude. And I just keep a chip on my shoulder until I get to that point. When I get to my point, I'm gonna keep a chip on my shoulder to stay there. Like, if you think I'm just athletic and like chipping, you gotta come see me play. You're gonna see something in the bag that you haven't seen before, you feel me?
Yo.
Why, Greg? Why am I doing that?
Because.
Because why?
Because you're mad because I put my arm in the rim.
Not because you put your hands on the rim. If you put your arm all the way through it,
I'm okay. I didn't put my hands on the rim, though.
If you put it all the way through, I'm okay with it. But when you're grabbing on my rim.
Hey, I didn't put my hands on the rim, though.
That one dunk you did.
What dunk?
When I walked in.
I know you're talking about.
Greg?
Someone missed a shot.
Apologize.
I know what you're talking about.
Apologize.
You know what you're talking about?
Apologize.
I know what you're talking about.
You better apologize.
I know what you're talking about, though.
I'll take off my belt.
I'm
take off my belt.
What belt? You don't have a belt on. You got sweatpants on. Love you, Greg.
Love you too, coach.